Today, we are going to look at a BodyViz Brain Builder, about the cardiovascular system, and a pacemaker. The cardiovascular system provides your body's organs with oxygen and nutrients so that they can perform their functions. The cardiovascular system consists of the heart and blood vessels. The blood vessels can be divided into two circuits, the pulmonary circuit and systemic circuit. The pulmonary circuit carries carbon dioxide-rich blood from the heart to the lungs, where gas exchange with blood occurs, and then returns the oxygen-rich blood back to the heart. The systemic circuit carries oxygen-rich blood from the heart to all of the organs of the body and returns the carbon dioxide-rich blood back to the heart. We will concentrate on the anatomy of the heart with this brain builder. The heart is composed of four chambers, a right and left atrium, and a right and left ventricle. The right atrium receives the carbon dioxide-rich blood from the periphery via the superior and inferior vena cava and the coronary circulation of the heart. The opening between the right atrium and right ventricle is the location of the right atrioventricular valve, which controls the flow between the right atrium and right ventricle. The left atrium forms most of the base of the heart, typically 3 to 4 pulmonary veins, which carry oxygen-rich blood from the lungs, empty into the left atrium. The walls of the left atrium are slightly thicker than those of the right atrium. The opening between the left atrium and left ventricle is the location of the left AV valve. The left ventricle receives blood from the left atrium and pumps it out via the aorta to all of the organs of the body. The contraction and relaxation of the chambers of the heart are highly coordinated during the cardiac cycle. This coordination is accomplished by specialized cardiac muscle cells that comprise the conducting system of the heart. The sinoatrial node is located near the opening of the superior vena cava into the right atrium. The internodal tracts extend from the SA node throughout the wall of the right atrium, terminating at the AV node in the posterior inferior portion of the interatrial septum. The bundle branches communicate with small, specialized cardiac muscle cells, termed Purkinje fibers, which are the terminal portions of the conducting system within the ventricles of the heart. An abnormal heartbeat or cardiac cycle is often due to dysfunction with one or more components of the conducting pathway system. If such a condition becomes chronic, a physician may recommend the implantation of a cardiac pacemaker to control the heartbeat or cardiac cycle. During the surgical procedure, one or more wires are inserted into a major vein under or near the clavicle. Each of the wires are secured into position at the appropriate position within your heart. The pulse generator is then implanted deep to the skin in close proximity to the clavicle. The pulse generator either provides constant stimulation to the heart to increase the heart rate, or will only electrically stimulate the heart when needed to correct an abnormal heartbeat. Having a pacemaker should improve overall symptoms caused by an abnormally slow or irregular heart rate, allowing the patient to resume a more active lifestyle. Next, we will look at the symptoms, causes, and treatments for bradycardia, and finally, give a patient example. Bradycardia is a slower than normal heart rate. A normal resting heart rate for adults is between 60 and 100 beats per minute. With bradycardia, oftentimes the heart beats fewer than 60 times a minute. Symptoms of bradycardia include chest pain, confusion or memory problems, dizziness or lightheadedness, easily tiring during physical activity, fatigue, fainting, or shortness of breath. Causes for bradycardia are heart tissue damage related to aging, heart disease, or a heart attack, heart disorder present at birth, inflammation of the heart, a complication of a heart surgery, an underactive thyroid gland, an imbalance of chemicals in the blood, and medications like sedatives, opioids, or other drugs used to treat heart rhythm disorders, high blood pressure, and certain mental health disorders. Treatments for bradycardia depend on the severity of the symptoms. Lifestyle changes, medications, and surgical implantation of a pacemaker are possible treatments. Finally, let's take a look at a patient example. Your patient is visiting for her yearly physical exam. You review your patient's file and take a look. Age, 60. Gender, female. Chief complaints, low energy, shortness of breath, and dizziness when exercising. Your patient lives a very active and healthy lifestyle. She is part of a bike club and rides 50 miles or more each week and has a healthy diet. In past checkups, you noted that she had low cholesterol and a low resting heart rate due to her healthy and active lifestyle. However, this visit, she reports that when she went out for her first spring bike ride, she felt that she had no energy, was very short of breath, and felt dizzy. She did not think it was anything to worry about because her heart rate still remained at 70 beats per minute, even during the most strenuous portions of her bike ride. You checked her vitals, which were 50 beats per minute for her resting heart rate and 90 over 50 for her resting blood pressure. Both of these are low. You are suspicious of a possible cardiovascular issue and have her perform a Harvard step test, which is when the patient steps up and down from a step at a pace goal of 30 completed steps per minute. When your patient is performing the test, you note rapid fatigue and dizziness. You have your patient wear a Holter monitor for the next week, which will keep track of your patient's heart rhythm. When your patient returns the following week, you inform her that she has a normal sinus rhythm. However, she's a significant bradycardia, both at rest and during exercise. You suggest surgically implanting a cardiac pacemaker so she can maintain her active lifestyle. Your patient thinks the procedure over and eventually agrees to it. After the pacemaker is implanted and she has recovered from the surgery, she returns back to her normal lifestyle. This is a classic example of a pacemaker and bradycardia. For more 3D anatomy videos, like this video and subscribe to our BodyViz channel.